Hi guys, welcome to our YouTube channel. And today is a very exciting day because we are trying this format of vlogging for the first time, and I am up to a very fun vlog, which is going and interviewing college going students. Okay, your makeup needs to be full coverage, so does your helmet. Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Our YouTube channel.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so you guys said you both ride helmets, right?
Yeah.
So there are, you
scooties, no bikes,
and you wear helmets.
Yeah.
Oh wow, I just spoke a whole bit without recording it. Okay.
No.
No.
Door bhi jana hai to kabhi kabhi nahi pehante.
Wanting to do that for a very long time. Going students, and it is very interesting because today I'm going to be meeting a few teenagers, college going students, etc., and asking them. Or, you know, getting to know if they know traffic rules and to what extent they follow traffic rules, and do they even understand the consequences of not following them. So I know this is not a generation to be preached to, but they're also the future of the country, so we thought this is a, you know, good initiative, keeping in mind that the World Brain Day is on July 22nd. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Yashaswini. I'm the social media coordinator of PRS Neurosciences. Now, PRS Neurosciences is a neuroscience company which is committed to neuromodulation with advanced neurorehabilitation. Now, these are very big words that I'm throwing at you, but it basically means that if there is a patient who's been caused, who has any sort of a neuro disability or an issue, which could be caused either by a traumatic incident or by a condition, a neurological condition. When I say traumatic incident, it could be a head injury, it could be road traffic accident, it could be stroke. And when I say an issue or like a neurological condition, it could be Parkinson's, dementia, etc. Due to whatever reason, if there is a neurological deficit or a deficiency in a patient and that is affecting their quality of life, we come into the picture and we help such patients get back to their lives. We help them regain their functional independence, as in they should be able to, like, you know, at least take care of themselves, dress themselves, be able to move by themselves, do their daily living activities by themselves. So we do this by either neuromodulation, that is any sort of a surgery that can help them maintain their condition or the symptoms, or we also do it with the help of neurorehabilitation, which is a combination of therapy where you are taught something repetitively, where you're made, you're given exercises, you're given other modalities to help you cope with these symptoms. Now, neurorehabilitation comes with a varied range of therapies, which is physiotherapy, occupational therapy, speech and swallow pathology, speech and language pathology, swallow therapy, cognitive therapy. We also have Ayurveda and pain management to help our patients more efficiently. That was a lot of talking. Anyway, now that being said, the reason, as much as I'm going to try and make this vlog fun, the reason that we are doing this is because lately we have seen people of very young age, of my age, you know, where 20, 25, 30 year old people are being, we either see them in a road traffic accident injury or a head injury, and it is just very, very disheartening and very, it is just very disheartening for us also to see patients like that. So this is just a social initiative on our end. This is going to be a fun day with a lot of vlogging, and this is my first time vlogging too, so it's going to be something that we both get to experience together. So hope you're ready for it, and let's go. Hello, safety first, but I'm continuing the vlog after a day because Bangalore rains. So let's go meet some college people. Hello sir. Yeah. Yes. So we are on the way, and I'm pretty sure I can spot so many people. So we will spot them together. Here we have our very first spotting. Here we have decided that the pillion rider's life is not really that much worth. We'll only wear safety helmet for the primary rider. Here we have one more uncle who is looking at his watch, casually riding without a helmet. And the irony is, the uncle was riding there. That is High Grounds Traffic Police Station grounds. So like that you go on like a helmet spotting, because I just saw a guy pick up a girl from the college, so obviously educated, and neither of them had helmets. So yeah, we should do this, like a helmet spotting weekend in Bangalore. We are near Mount Carmel College, which is in Bengaluru, and I'm on the hunt for students, if they have a helmet, if they don't have a helmet, and if they have one, is it good enough? What do you ride?
Yes, Ether.
Okay.
Electric.
Great. So electric vehicles don't had some rule about helmets, mm-hmm. and then they were made mandated again. So do you guys use a helmet?
Yes,
of course. We have to. It goes faster than normal petrol vehicles, actually.
Right. So which kind of helmet do you use?
I think full face.
Are you sure?
Yes. Yeah, like mine not, hers is full yahan tak, mine doesn't cover the chin, it only covers my ear.
And why is that?
Because I feel suffocated.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. But just for your information and not to scare you at all, maybe to scare you a little bit, the helmet that does not have a jaw protection can end up in a jaw injury. And it's very gory.
Correct.
So anyway, I'm glad to know that you do use helmets.
Yes.
So thank you. So all of you ride a bike or a scooty or sort of a vehicle, right? So guys, tell me honestly, har bar jab bahar nikalte ho, mummy kuch bolti hai dukaan se lane ko, every time you wear a helmet?
No. Door bhi jana hai to kabhi nahi pehante.
Helmet irritate karta hai yaar, actually bole to.
Okay, how? Explain.
अरे वो थोड़ा लाइक बड़ा वाला
बाल खराब कर देता
है, बाल खराब कर देता है हमारे.
ओके, दैट्स अ वेरी जेन्युइन कंसर्न. एंड देन
बाकी तो कुछ नहीं.
अच्छा, बाल ने आपका सर भी खराब हो सकता है?
गरम होता है
सर, गरम होता है.
नॉट गरम, खराब. इफ यू डू गेट इट, गॉड फॉरबिड यू गेट इट टू एन एक्सीडेंट, इट डज यू नो रियली डैमेज योर होल लाइफ, राइट? सो ओके, सो यू वर अ राइडर, बट आई हैव सीन राइडर्स get like completely, like they wear jackets and they wear big helmets and all of that. So how, why is riding, when you go for a ride with your friends it's different, and when you are in the city it's different?
Yeah, like in what way are you asking me about the
riding? The gear that you wear, about helmets, etc.
It's like it's kind of a official riding, so we go in a group and you know, we actually go to the highway, so speeding is a big thing, you know.
But we do have speeding in normal roads, don't we?
Yeah, but it's like, it's not a highway thing and it's not risky.
Right.
And there it's risky, so we wear riding jackets and
stuff. Okay, fair. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hi girls.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, so you both ride some sort of a two-wheeler or a vehicle, right? Do you both use helmets?
Yes, we do.
Okay. And what kind of helmet do you use?
I don't know what it's called.
No, that's okay. But how is it too?
It's rounded with the.
Does it cover here?
Yeah, no, it doesn't cover.
No, okay. So these are the typical like women's helmet. Whatever is marketed as a women's helmet, right? Okay. So do you think that does enough for protecting you, your head against injuries?
No, I think it should be covered fully.
Right. So we hope, even though you know the bigger helmets are heavier, we hope you switch to them, because it does not cover your jaw, and jaw injuries are extremely painful. So we hope, you know, you, and when your friend ever starts to ride, all of you use a good quality helmet, ISI-certified helmets. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay. So you guys told me you aren't riders, but my question is, you still are pillion riders, right? You sit behind people who ride. So what are the, now we have to use a helmet because that's a rule in Bangalore. Mm-hmm. So what kind of helmet do you use?
I didn't know there were different kinds.
When like I get on a Rapido, whichever helmet they give, which is like those construction worker
kind of
helmets.
Yeah.
Yeah, those.
The cap helmet
thing. Yeah, those.
Right. So do you consciously, if you are a user of Rapido, do you consciously carry a helmet with you?
No. I just use what they give.
Okay. And what about you?
Yeah, the same thing. If they have a helmet, I probably use that. But
right. Okay.
Yeah.
So we would just like to tell you that the amount of like road traffic accidents, this is not meant to scare you, and it's okay if it scares you a little bit. But you know, the amount of road traffic accidents that we see, and we get patients. Now, I agree, you know, with your college, it's difficult to carry a huge helmet. It's annoying, right? We understand that. But it's very, you know, unsafe. Those kind of short helmets, those cap helmets are extremely unsafe. And, you know, it doesn't do any job of protecting your head. And we know there's no rule as such. But again, you know, it's our job to protect our head, right? Yeah. So I hope you start carrying a good quality, ISI certified, fully covered helmet, okay? Your makeup needs to be full coverage, so does your helmet. Yeah? Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you.
You guys told me you don't ride a two-wheeler, but I'm pretty sure you sit behind people who do.
Yep.
Right? Yeah. You take rapidos or you're traveling with a friend or whatever. You sit behind people, right? Do you use a helmet when you do that?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, good. Now, do you carry a helmet of your own or is it usually whatever your friend has or whatever the rapido guy has?
Whatever my friend has.
Right. So, okay. And usually, which kind of a helmet is it?
Like the cap sort.
Right, the cap sort. And I'm glad that you know that it's like a cap. It does not do the job of protecting your head or your brain from any sorts of injuries. So we do hope that you get good quality ISI certified helmets. I know it's a very annoying thing to carry around with your books and that's already heavy and the helmet is all the more annoying. But it is something very important for your own lives. So we hope you start doing that. Yeah? Thank you so much.
Hi boys. Good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon.
Right?
You
guys use helmets on a regular basis?
Yeah.
Yes. Which kind of helmet do you
use? Full helmet. Full helmet with the
shield.
With the screen. Yeah, visor and
everything. Yes,
okay,
yes.
Great.
So you both have some cool printed ISI certified helmets?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Great. That's good to know. And do you usually carry an extra helmet or something if you're dropping your friends?
No.
Okay. And be honest with me. Still wear proper helmets even if your mom says
you
go buy coriander from the shop next door
and
come.
No,
that time you don't.
Like if it's nearby, if it's nearby, we don't.
Explain how that works. If it's nearby, there's no gadis on the road.
That's correct, but
there's still threat on the road. So you put so much effort into your gear and your gadis and your helmet. Flaunt them, wear them every time that you go.
Sure.
So much. Okay, so you guys said you both ride helmets, right?
Yeah.
So there are, you ride scooters
no bikes
and you wear helmets.
Yeah.
So is it the cap kind of helmet, the full covered helmet or the half one that covers till here?
The half one. Has kind of like a mirror shield on
right.
it. Yeah, that one.
So the half one is usually marketed as a women's helmet,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Okay. Like most women's product, it does not do anything for us.
It doesn't really cover the jaw.
So we hope you buy ISI certified full coverage helmets. Now we know it's very annoying and it's very heavy to carry and all of that, but I think it's a necessary step to protect your head. So please, I hope you do the switch.
Thank you.
Yes, hi.
Hi.
Okay, so I see that you are carrying two helmets. One is the one that we recommend. It's an ISI certified and the other one is there. So who is this second helmet for? And do you usually carry this for whoever is riding a pillion?
Yeah, I do carry it. Who is behind me?
Okay. Right. So why did you choose your helmet? I'm very intrigued. So I'm pretty sure you must have thought a lot about your bike and all the gear and the accessories you're going to use for it. So why did you choose your black nice helmet?
So basically, I'm the one who always go for rides and all. I go alone usually just because I have my friends, so this one is for them. And black is my favorite color, so and it suits the bike, so I go with the black color.
The helmet that you're carrying for your friend doesn't really do anything for their head. You do realize that as a rider.
I do, but nothing, just nothing.
Yeah, but it's difficult to carry two big helmets and the cops will make you wear a helmet, right? So I know this is a convenient option, but we do encourage you to at least ask your friend to start carrying an ISI certified helmet just like yours so that it protects their head also. Yeah?
Yeah.
Hi there. So I see you're riding a vehicle and I unfortunately do not see a helmet. So where is your helmet and what is happening?
I didn't wear it because I just took it out from parking and we knew we'll take a pit stop here. So I will pull it out as soon as the coffee is out, actually.
Okay. That's good to know. But can you show us what kind of a helmet you use? Right. Yes, it's matchy-matchy with your vehicle. But I do see that this is the kind of helmet that most of us have, and it is usually marketed as a woman's helmet, right? It's for sure. So I'm glad you've taken a ISI-certified helmet, but then I hope you switch to a full coverage one. I know it's annoying, I know it's heavy, but...
I have the other one, but this fits my head better. Okay. Like, it's tight enough. The other one keeps slipping on even though I tighten the belt.
Right.
So I chose this.
Our helmet manufacturers. If you notice in the footage where I spoke to the last girl, she was very sweet and I do see her perspective. But if you saw when I asked her to show me her helmet, she had to wait a little time to like let the vehicles pass, and then only she could get down and open the dickey and show me the helmet, right? So this is a pretty busy road, especially when all the classes have let go for the day. So there are a lot of people walking around and a lot of vehicles going around. So even though it's a short distance, I think it's very important that they use their helmet. But for most of them, their concerns were actually legit, and it is helmet marketing manufacturer companies that market these half helmets as women's helmet. It is true that it doesn't fit all everybody properly and all of that. So it was a pretty interesting experience for me, not just with the format of this video, but also the content of this video and the sort of people that I got to interact with. We don't do a lot of videos with general normal youth. So we hope you liked it too. Please do leave your comments and thoughts in the comment section below, and I would love to read them. Thank you.